Now, the expense of dying can sometimes be through the roof, and that can be particularly difficult for the family grieving the new heartbreak. Now, in this special report, Jervis Manahan explores how families can brace for financial realities of laying their loved ones to rest.
They say material things do not count at the hour of death, but when someone passes away, burying one can be costly. The flowers, casket, and the lot for burial can cost a fortune. So how much should the family prepare to decently grieve and bury a deceased family member? It can actually be free if you are a resident of Quezon City.
Sa ngayon kasi, sir, bali, nakamuha kasi tayo sa city government kay Miura, project ni Mayor Joy Belmonte sa libreng serbisyo po. Kaya yung mga family po, yung gustong paservisyo ng libre, libre po lahat yun. Pati libingan, registration, ng mga death certificate, kami na po lahat nun.
The free package includes a casket, transportation to the cemetery, embalming, and other services. For those able to pay, packages start at 20,000 pesos to 100,000 pesos.
Pangmasa lang po tayo. Funeral service na po lahat-lahat.
Lahat-lahat.
Oh, hatid sa cemetery gan. Services, pick up, embalming, casket, viewing ng 5 days. Pag may chapel po, iba na yun sa kanila na po yun.
Burial lots cost a lot, but spaces in apartment time tombs in public cemeteries are free for the first 5 years. Manila and other LGUs in Metro Manila offer similar services.
Meron din po tayong paupers burial dito na kung saan tayo po, wala akong binabayaran yung ating po mga kababayan. Kailangan lang po nila ng certificate of indigency na manggagaling sa barangay nila tapos kami na po lahat.
Funeral packages are more accessible now as they are also present in social media platforms. So your preferred funeral service can just be one click away. Jervis Manahan, ABS-CBN News.
Let's now get an update on the situation at the Manila Memorial Park from our correspondent Karen De Guzman. Hi, Karen. Good morning.
Stanley, the Manila Memorial Park in Sukat, Paranaque is now open 24 hours to accommodate visitors paying their respects to their departed loved ones. The park will remain open 24 hours daily until November 2nd. On November 3, it will operate from 12 midnight to 6 p.m. Then we'll resume regular operating hours of 6 a.m. to 6 p.m. come November 4. Since Sunday, over 80,000 visitors have been recorded by the management. The park is expecting around 1 million visitors for All Saints Day and All Souls Day, which is higher from the figure recorded last year. According to Assistant Park Manager Engineer Rizalina Costa, they expect more visitors this year due to an increase in burials, more relatives visiting, and it eased restrictions since the pandemic. Unlike other cemeteries, visitors can spend the night inside the park. Stanley, notable personalities are laid to rest here, including members of the Aquino family, Kapamilya actors Rico Yan and AJ Perez, and slain broadcast journalist Percy Lapid. Local authorities have issued advisories to help manage the influx of visitors to cemeteries and ease traffic congestion. The Paranaque City government has implemented a one-way traffic scheme along Dr. A. Santos Avenue. The U-turn slot has also been temporarily closed. Light to moderate traffic is expected along the major public and other private cemeteries. Tow trucks are also on standby, ready to immediately respond to accidents. Traffic enforcers, medical units, and the Philippine National Police have been deployed to ensure safety and security during UNDAS 2024. Stanley.
All right, Karen De Guzman, again, thank you so much for that update. Passenger traffic at the Cubao bus terminal has decreased due to the recent typhoon's impact on travel plans. Liza Aquino filed this report.
Those planning to commute via bus to their provinces for the long weekend, now is a good time to head out. According to some dispatchers, more slots are available for passengers this morning. Norman Mercilla, a bus dispatcher at a terminal in Cubao, Quezon City, said that they have around 90 buses ready for deployment to various areas in Camarines Norte and Camarines Sur. So far, only the air-conditioned buses going to Camarines Norte are fully booked, while there are still plenty of seats available for the ordinary buses. He also noted that the recent typhoon has affected their passenger count with a decline in numbers compared to last year's UNDA.
Mamaya pa po yung tanghal, gawa ng half day pa mga trabaho ngayon. Kaya ba, mga alas 12, mamaya mag-umpisa na po ng dagsa ng pasahero.
Passengers are heading home to visit their departed loved ones. Passenger June Kahukom is using the long weekend to visit his family in Lemri, Batangas, and check on his house, which was nearly damaged during a landslide caused by Typhoon Christine last week. Meanwhile, Maryam Gardose, along with four of her relatives, booked an early trip to Iloilo and arrived at the terminal around 1 in the morning. They brought a flat screen TV and other appliances for their relatives in the province.
Marami kaming dala, mami, kaya kailangan maano kami. Early kami makapunta.
Uwi nga ako doon kasi yung bahay namin, yung lupa rito, gumuho. Eh, hindi naman nakakun yung bahay namin. Alisin namin yung lupa.
Of this hour, walk-in passengers will have no problem booking a ticket going to Santa Cruz, Lemery, Nasugbu, and other areas in Batangas, but there are still plenty of slots available in the LTB bus terminal and Alps bus terminal in Cubao. Air-conditioned bus trips going to Bicol, however, are already fully booked. Authorities remind passengers not to bring any flammable materials, weapons, firearms, and other prohibited items inside the terminal. They're expecting the influx of passengers starting this afternoon until tomorrow morning.
Turning now to updates on the UNDAS exodus, passenger numbers are rising at major transport hubs in the Philippines as the All Saints and All Souls Day break begins. Despite bad weather, the Philippine Ports Authority anticipates around 1.6 million passengers nationwide. However, small vessels and fast craft trips are canceled at the Batangas port due to rough seas. The ports also open a new gate to ease passenger entry and exit.
Para kayo ligtas na, dalawang punghakbang lang. Ay, nandito na kayo sa loob ng compound ng Batangas port.
Mas maganda po ngayon kasi po wala na pong nangaharang sa amin para magbenta ng pilitin kaming bumili sa kanila. Dati po pinipilit nila kami.
Meanwhile, transport authorities inspected the Paranaque Integrated Terminal Exchange, or PITX, on Wednesday to monitor the situation. Three bus drivers tested positive during random drug testing.
Agad-agad naman kinumpiska yung mga lisensya nito at di na sila pinayagang makapagmaneho. So, magsasailalim sila sa confirmatory test.
So far, maayos naman. Sa tingin ko, sa dami ng mga nandito ngayon, eh, sufficient naman yung personnel ng lahat ng mga agencies.
The local government of Manila and police conduct an inspection of the Manila North Cemetery ahead of the deluge of visitors for the All Saints and All Souls Day holidays. They checked on the status of the command post and first aid station and made the rounds of the area. Private vehicles are now barred from entering, but there are 40 e-trikes giving free rides. Some 1.5 million people are expected to visit starting today until the weekend.
Alas po ngayon ng North Cemetery. Kung makikita nyo, bagong-bago na po ang ating signage pagpasok po ng North Cemetery. Malinis na po ang North Cemetery. Handang-handa na pong tumanggap sa napakarami tanting mga kababayan na pupunta dito magsimula ngayong araw hanggang sa November 3. Meron po tayo mga kapulisan, 400 po na pulis, dalawang shift po sa loob. May mga post po sila para to make sure na protektado po ang ating po mga kababayan.
In Dangwa, Manila, flower prices are mixed as eager buyers rush to find perfect blooms for their departed loved ones. Job Manahan has more.
Flower prices here remained unpredictable and high as of 6 a.m. today, with vendors citing different reasons. Some flower vendors said they have to raise flower prices to 50 pesos because of high prices from their supplier in China. Meanwhile, some said they have to drop flower prices from 10 pesos to 20 pesos due to low demand. Others said their prices before the peak remained the same, so they would be able to sell all of their flowers before November 2. Basket of flowers range from 200 pesos to 1,500 pesos depending on the size and their design. Some bouquet of Malaysian mums, chrysanthemums, and sunlight are priced between 300 pesos and 500 pesos. A bundle of orchids, meanwhile, are priced at 550 pesos, higher than the usual 500 pesos. A bundle of sunflowers are priced between 300 pesos to 1,000 pesos, depending on their size. Vendors are also selling wreaths and baskets of dried flowers that range from 150 pesos to 2,000 pesos, depending on its size and complexity of its design. Fresh flowers usually dry after a week, according to vendors, so it is important to keep them in water to lengthen their lifespan. One of the customers we talked to, such as Lloyd Hoxon, said she opted to buy flowers a day before Undas so these would remain fresh. She offers them to her late husband's grave in Laguna tomorrow. For the traffic situation, the traffic remained moderate to heavy along Laonglaan Street as some customers brought their cars with them. Light to moderate traffic can be experienced along Lacson Avenue.
New York's Times Square gets ready to mark the Day of the Dead. Three new sculptures have been installed at a major commercial intersection ahead of the annual celebration. The three statues are colorful representations of the Mexican holiday Dia de los Metros o Muertos, when, according to beliefs, the dead return to Earth to visit their loved ones.
I lost my daughter 9 years ago, so I have a big shrine for her and everything, and but it's so beautiful to have this, you know, and then I'll be able to, I like that Dia de los Muertos, and then they say you have to have pictures of your loved ones, you know, and if you don't, their spirit's not, you know, free, so, but yeah, I mean, I think they're beautiful. I just realized them right now, so I took some pictures, and yeah, see how it goes out.
Dia de los Muertos is often celebrated on November 1st as a day to remember children who have passed away, and on November 2nd to honor adults. The Energy Regulatory Commission has directed distribution utilities in the country to ease consumer burden following the order from President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. All distribution utilities in areas declared under a state of calamity due to Storm Christine must suspend disconnections for consumers with monthly consumption below 200 kilowatt hours for unpaid bills from October to December 2024. They are also required to offer flexible payment options. Consumers with usage below 200 kilowatt hours can pay their bills on a staggered basis over 6 months. All right, an update on the weather now. Violent weather conditions being felt in Batanes as Super Typhoon Leon moves over the seas of extreme northern Luzon. Now, the storm was last located 110 kilometers north-northeast of Itbayat, Batanes, packing winds of 195 kilometers per hour and gusts of up to 240 kilometers per hour. Tropical cyclone wind signal number 4 is in effect over the whole of Batanes, while the northern portion of Babuyan Islands is under signal number 3. Leon is forecast to weaken into a typhoon after it makes landfall over Taiwan. It may exit the Philippine area of responsibility tonight or tomorrow morning. That's November 1st. Danish firm Maersk opened its largest Philippine distribution center. Pia Gutierrez filed this report.
President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. on Wednesday led the launch of the Maersk Optimus Distribution Center, a massive 10-hectare, 76,000-pallet capacity facility in Calamba, Laguna, which is seen to boost the country's import and export activities, particularly in southern Luzon. According to Maersk, their largest facility in the Philippines will integrate major warehouse operational and co-packing activities to cater to key industry verticals such as consumer goods, food and beverage, leisure and lifestyle, healthcare, technology, automotive, and retail. It is also expected to create direct employment for 1,000 people in its surrounding communities, as well as indirect employment for another 1,000 individuals. Let's listen to President Marcos Jr. as well as Dominic Gates, the global head of the Maersk Contract Logistics.
With the grand opening of the Maersk Optimus Distribution Center, our logistics system will be a step closer to become a powerful force, bridging our islands, breathing life into our industries, our businesses, bringing together our people on a path towards sustained development.
The completion of this facility stands as a powerful symbol of Maersk's global commitment to a new and brighter future for the Philippines. I'm very excited about the Philippines generally. It's not just our largest market in ASEAN. It's going to be one of our top drivers going forward for many, many years.
The strategic location of the distribution center aligns with the administration's efforts to decongest Manila and unlock the economic potential of the countryside. Despite the challenges experienced during the pandemic, the Philippine logistics sector currently employs about 3.68 million Filipinos, ranking second only to the construction sector as the fastest growing industry in the Philippines. The president also noted that the Philippines logistics sector has shown marked improvement in competitiveness, climbing to the 43rd spot out of 139 economies in the World Bank's 2023 Logistics Performance Index from its previous place at 60th in 2018. He attributes this to the sector's gains in customs efficiency, infrastructure quality, and on-time deliveries.
The Education Department and software company teams up to boost the skills of Filipino teachers. Starting in November, DepEd teachers will receive free access and training on Canva for Education. Education Secretary Sonny Angara says the initiative aims to enhance digital design and creativity in Filipino classrooms, offering user-friendly tools for interactive learning. Canva for Education will be available at no cost to all K-12 schools, teachers, and students. The program will initially provide pilot training to select DepEd personnel, with a phased rollout to 17 regions set to begin in January 2025. The Philippine government's debt slightly rose in September. Data from the Treasury Bureau show it stood at 15.89 trillion pesos last month. That's 2.2% higher month on month. The Treasury, however, maintains the debt level remains 69% of it were borrowed from local lenders. Foreign debt went up by 4.2%, sitting at 4.96 trillion pesos. The agency notes the peso's appreciation in September paired off over 2.4 billion in the overall external debt. Philippine crypto players believe investors in the sector are anticipating a Donald Trump victory. The Republican nominee has positioned himself as a pro-crypto candidate. Earlier this year, Mr. Trump vowed to make America the crypto capital of the world, gaining the support of several business moguls in the digital asset space who have endorsed and donated to his campaign.
A lot of people who have heard the Trump narrative that, you know, he is pro-crypto. And I think what we're seeing this week especially is that the market is pricing in that knowledge, especially since the prediction markets are thinking that Trump is almost two to one favorite against his opponent, Kamala Harris. So I think what we're seeing here is the market expecting a Trump victory and then also kind of trying to front run that opportunity. Not to mention that October traditionally is a very good month for Bitcoin.
At least. In addition to sort of the Trump, sort of the, you know, the catalyst from a Trump win in the next couple of weeks, I think sure you saw the Fed sort of lowering rates by 50 bips, you know, about a month ago, and with basically, you know, signaling, which signals the market that, you know, the Fed is actually going to start cutting rates, or is a signal of a declining sort of a rate, which basically means that you're going to see more liquidity coming back into the market. And Bitcoin as a whole, I think, is the most sensitive sort of asset with regards to sort of like, you know, liquidity. Closer we are to the November 5th election date, Bitcoin price is going to match Trump's prediction market price.